يا مفتى وتنحت جسمك الساعات نحتا وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتا تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها حتى إذا مت انتبهتا فكم ذا أنت مخدوع وحتى متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى
أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا إن نهيت وإن أمرتا
ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب به مقاتل من أردتا وكنز لا تخاف عليه لصا خفيف الحمل يوجد حيث كنت.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمدٍ وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسانٍ إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I'm your host Karim AbuZaid and I come live. This is a live broadcast. Today is Monday and we happen to have the Right Believe series, volume 1, which is we're about to finish, one more lecture, which we chose to call it Know Your Lord. In that volume, we will, or we already explained the Lordship of Allah and the names and the attributes. And this is lecture number 14. We're going to practice today Ihsa for the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names. Man ahsaha dakhal al-jannah. We talked about the four meanings of ahsaha last lecture. And today, inshallah, we will exercise, practice, apply what we have studied last lecture on the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman. We have one more lecture in this section of the Right Belief series, which is Mabhath Ismullah al-A'zam, the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is next Monday. And with this, inshallah, we will begin reviewing for the test. Some of you may not know that we have a competition coming up by the end of this month, July 31st, in that section of the Right Belief series, in volume 1 of the Right Belief series. And alhamdulillah, the book is about to be ready and released, called Know Your Lord, Brothers and Sisters in Islam. Inshallah, hopefully, you will get a chance to buy it or get it in Amazon, inshallah, bi'idhni Allah ta'ala. Know Your Lord, that's the name of the book which we chose to present to you, inshallah, bi'idhni Allah ta'ala. So this is what we have, inshallah. Let's begin our lecture today, inshallah, bi'idhni Allah ta'ala. which is the practice of the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman, inshallah, bi-idhni Allah ta'ala. You shall enjoy that. I love this name personally, and for me is like really, you know, a very special name in particular to me, subhanallah, yani. Believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman. طيب, we're about ready here, inshallah, bi-idhni Allah. Let's do that. I wanted to say one more thing before I begin the lecture. Yes, today is the last day for registering. I was alerted. Tomorrow, actually, is the last day. July 7th is the last day. There will be no more registrations accepted after the 7th of July. Inshallah, bi-idhni Allah ta'ala. Okay, let's begin. The name of Allah, Ar-Rahman. So remember, this is the Right Belief series. This is important. And the Right Belief series of Islam will have volume number one, which is no you. And this number four, the name of Allah is clear. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names, 100 minus one, who is Ahla. For these 99 were Jannah, basically. So this is the hadith which we have here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names, 100 minus one. Whoever does Ihsa for these names will be admitted to Jannah. طيب, we explained the meaning of Ahsaha last lecture. We said Ahsaha, brothers and sisters in Islam, is way more than a lot of people think now. Unfortunately, a lot of Muslims are under the impression that Ahsaha is just to say them. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, and actually they say them in a bid'i way, in a way that shows bid'ah, yani. Rather, Ahsaha, brothers and sisters in Islam, means, number one, that you must bring them from the reliable sources. You must bring them from the reliable sources. Two, understand the name correctly. That is two. Three, act upon the name. The effects which this name should have on you. And four, to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using this name. To praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using this name. So let's practice today the name of Allah Ar-Rahman. We will explain how to implement the four purposes of the blessed name Ar-Rahman. Remember, Ahsaha means, these are the four things right here. I got them for you. Count and memorize from reliable sources. Understand the name correctly. Act upon the name, calling upon Allah, or calling Allah, making dua, yani, using the name. What do you mean by reliable sources? Because we know, for me to say Allah has this name, I must have an evidence. That's what I mean. So if we go into number one, the evidence, the first meaning of Ahsaha is to count, meaning to say, to utter, to memorize, based on the opinion of Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. But to do so, we must validate the name first. Meaning, we must provide an evidence for the name from the Quran and the Sunnah. So that's the first step to do Ihsa. Is this name authentic or not? Okay, authentic meaning it was mentioned in the Quran. in the Sunnah or just in the Quran or just in the Sunnah? One of the brothers asked, what about names which were not mentioned in the Quran, just in the Sunnah? Can we still use them? Absolutely, brothers and sisters in Islam. We must do that. طيب, as long as you validated the chain of transmitters, as long as the hadith is not weak, the hadith is authentic. طيب, اسم الله الرحمن in the Quran, the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman, appears in the Quran in 57 places. This is actually number 3 in the list. Allah, then Ar-Rahim, then Ar-Rahman. Number 3 in the highest number, the highest name mentioned or appearing in the Quran. After Allah, the proper name, and after Ar-Rahim. So certainly we have enough evidence from the Quran to state that the name of Allah Ar-Rahman is mentioned. The name of Allah Ar-Rahman is the only name of Allah on which a chapter of the Quran is named and based around it. That's another big evidence there. The only chapter in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala name, the only name, divine name of Allah, Allah chose a whole chapter to name after it. What is the name of the chapter? Ar-Rahman. Imagine this. Ar-Rahman, 'allama al-Qur'an, khalaqa al-insan. Here is one evidence. قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن أيما تدعوا فله الأسماء الحسنى ولا تجهر بصلاتك ولا تخافت بها وابتغ بين ذلك سبيلا. سورة الإسراء, chapter 17, verse 110. Look at it. Beautiful. Call me Allah or call me Ar-Rahman. Call upon me using the proper name Allah or the divine name Ar-Rahman. قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن. That's the evidence. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in spite of the fact that you have the name mentioned repeatedly in the Quran, but it's a good practice to always include an evidence from the Sunnah. Always. Always. It's nice. You don't have to in this particular case. I don't have to. But it's nice. The name of Allah Ar-Rahman also appears in the Sunnah. Appears in many hadith. We chose this hadith Qudsi. Allah, al-hadith al-Bukhari, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أنا الرحمن وهذا الرحم شققت لها اسما من اسمي فمن وصلها قطعته وصلته ومن قطعها قطعته. الله أكبر. الله سبحانه وتعالى saying أنا الرحمن, I am الرحمن, and وهذا الرحم, and this is الرحم. You know what الرحم means? The womb of the mother where the baby spends the 7, 8, 9 months. Could be 6 months too, based on the opinion of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. But the term Ar-Rahman or Ar-Rahim, the womb, refers to the kinship ties. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أنا الرحمن, and this is the kinship ties. I made the name of the kinship ties, I made the name of the kinship ties derive from my name, الرحمن. Allahu Akbar. So whoever uphold his kinship ties, I will show him mercy, basically. And whoever severs his kinship ties, I will sever him. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. That's an evidence in the Sunnah. So we're done with number one. Imagine that. We're done with number one. Done with number one, which is what? Ihsa. Now we can say Ar-Rahman. Ya Rahman. Ya Rahman. Ar-Rahman. Ya Rabbi Irhamni. Ya Rabbi Ya Rahman. Irhamni. Now I can, because I have an evidence. Let's move to number two. The second meaning, or the second purpose of the command Ahsaha. The correct understanding of the name. We affirm the name. The first thing that we must do to show that you correctly understood the name is to affirm the name and affirm the attribute. Because we have an evidence. Because some people said what? We're okay with the name Ar-Rahman. But the attribute Ar-Rahmah, which is the mercy, no. Because mercy shows weakness, and they come up with these rational arguments, which has no place with the evidence. So we affirm also the attribute which the name implies, which is the attribute of mercy, but away, in a way. Because, yeah, Rahmah, when a person shows Rahmah, when a human created being show Rahmah, you show weakness, you show compassion, you show feelings. Would Allah know? So we affirm the attribute of mercy in a way which suits His Majesty's greatness and perfection. Now there, we have another task once it comes to some names in the Quran, that very close names to them, like Ar-Rahim, we have Ar-Rahim. We have Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Now, another way or another step which you have to take in order to manifest your correct understanding of the name, you must distinguish the two names which are very close in meaning, especially if they were paired, meaning mentioned together in a single text, in one text, in the Quran or in the Sunnah. Bismillah, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Those are two names. They were mentioned together in Al-Basmala, and they were mentioned together, they appeared together in six places in the Quran. We go back to the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, who said regarding words or terms like these, he given them the name Al-Fadun Mushtaraka. These are terms which have mutual meanings. إِذَا اجْتَمَعَا اِفْتَرَقَا وَإِذَا افْتَرَقَا اِجْتَمَعَا. When they are mentioned together, إِذَا اجْتَمَعَا, if they do اجْتِمَاعَ together, افْتَرَقَا فِي الْمَعْنَى. They have two different meanings. But إِذَا افْتَرَقَا, meaning if they are mentioned individually, there is firaq between them, individual mention of them, اجْتَمَعَا. Ar-Rahman could mean Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahim could mean Ar-Rahman. When they are mentioned individually in a sentence, they will mean the same thing. Normally, the context of the sentence will be the decider which one of the two. I think we understand that. So let's talk about the similarities between the two names to begin with. The two names are about Allah's attribute of mercy, Ar-Rahman, the most compassionate or the most gracious, Ar-Rahim, the most merciful. Although both names imply the quality of mercy, but the two names do not mean the same thing because they appeared in al-Basmala to begin with and in six different places in the Quran. طيب, what are the differences? Ar-Rahman indicates to Allah's mercy as an attribute of the essence. What does that mean? Ar-Rahman is a name of the essence. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it equal to his name Allah. When he said in the verse I just cited in Surah Al-Isra, قُلْ اِدْعُوا اللَّهَ أَوْ اِدْعُوا الرَّحْمَانِ. Call upon me using Allah, the proper name, which is the name which include all the attributes, or Ar-Rahman, because Ar-Rahman is the name of the essence. And we have more than one evidence to prove that you're not supposed to take that name without Abd al-Rahman. Without Abd al-Rahman. You're not allowed to take on that, to name yourself with it, or name your children with it, using Rahman. And very unfortunate, a lot of Muslims, they call themselves Rahman. Or Ar-Rahman, wal-ayadu billah. This is exclusive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The evidence also for this, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam saying, the most beloved names to Allah, Abdullah wa Abdul Rahman. So that shows you that both names are names of the essence. The other evidence which establish that Ar-Rahman is a name which pertains to the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah chose that name to be paired with the act of al-istiwa ala al-arsh. Ar-Rahman ala al-arsh istawa. And we know al-arsh is the place which is above the creation. Ala al-arsh istawa. But Ar-Rahim is an attribute which is connected to the divine will of Allah. In other words, Ar-Rahman is related to Allah's most comprehensive and encompassing mercy and his eternal mercy, while Ar-Rahim indicates Allah's practical mercy or special mercy. That is why there are some translations of the Quran. I wouldn't say translations because you really can't translate the Quran, but the meanings in English. The entirely merciful, the specially merciful. They do that. Some of the people who did the meanings in English, and I heard it a couple of times in the recording, when they recite the meanings of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, they say what? In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the specially merciful. Entirely merciful in reference to Ar-Rahman, specially merciful in connection or in relation to Ar-Rahim. I think you're getting the point here, inshallah. We explained that. طيب. So we're done with two now. We understood the name correctly. We distinguished the name from other names which may be very close. Actually, this is the closest a name can be to another name. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, in my opinion. There is Afu, Ghafur, Ghaffar, Ghafir. Also, these are very close, but Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim is extremely close. Now, we need to remember the types of names Allah have, the four types. Because number three has to do with that. Number three has to do with that. So let's remember that. Types of the names of Allah are four. Names which are appropriate for us to train ourselves to develop attributes, but in a human context, of course. So there are certain names that it's okay to exercise them, but in our human capacity, you will find out that Ar-Rahman is one of them, that we're supposed to be merciful, and we're supposed to develop the attribute of mercy if we don't have it. So this is number one. There are other names which are exclusive to Allah, like Al-Jabbar, Al-Jabbar, the compeller, Al-Mutakabbir, the possessor of pride. We must affirm these names, limit them to Allah, and don't try to exercise them, because they are exclusive to Allah. Al-Kibriya'u Rida'i Wal-Azamatu Izari Faman Naza'ani Fihima Adkhaltuhu Nari Wala Ubali. Bride is mine. Allah is saying that whoever is created by me, competes with me in that area, he will enter hellfire. No Jannah for this person. Because no one in reality qualifies to have bride. Because we all created, we all need, we all weak. And if we're not weak now, we're going to be weak later. That's the way it is. That's the only one who's free of any needs is Allah. The only one who is independent is Allah. We all are dependents, whether upon one another or whether upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For we're not supposed to exercise, but we're supposed to affirm these names so we increase our reverence, our love, our hope in Allah, our fear, khashya, reverential fear in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are names which simply imply a promise or hope. All what we have to do is to increase our love and have hope. There are names which imply a warning. They should increase our reverential fear and avoid these names. So the name of Allah Ar-Rahman, it has to be one or two, three or four. Look at this now. The name of Allah Ar-Rahman happens to be number one. It is appropriate for us to exercise it.
in our human context, and it has a promise. It increases our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should add to your love for Allah. It should add to your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're good. Now let's step into step number three. The effects. Should have an S there because it should have more than one effect. This name, Ar-Rahman, should have on us. If you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being Ar-Rahman, that should impact you. That should increase your love for Allah. And normally the love should be followed, the true love, with obedience. And loving to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, loving Allah and loving His commands. Loving Allah and loving the things He loves. Loving Allah and loving to do the things He told you to do. Loving Allah and loving to stay away from the things He told you to stay away from. It's not, that's what love is. That's the true meaning of love. Any other is a claim, which a lot of Muslims unfortunately do. If you ask an average Muslim, do you love Allah? He will say yes, 100%. Well, what happened? Hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah. What happened to that? A sign. Ata'si al-ilaha وأنت تزعم حبه. Do you obey? Do you disobey? Do you disobey Allah while you claim that you love Him? Come on. This is a bad analogy. هذا في القياس يعني, if you, that's a bad analogy. Let me show you just one hadith, brothers and sisters in Islam, and you can imagine this. Just ponder upon this. Allah is more merciful to His slaves than this mother to her baby. This hadith in al-Bukhari wa Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hadith Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu. This woman is more merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more merciful to us, to His slaves, than this woman to her child. What is the mawridul hadith? Mawridul hadith is the occasion in which the Prophet made that statement. Imagine right after one of the battles, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is standing and he is surrounding with his companions. Umar radiallahu anhu is the one who narrates this author. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions spotted a mother. Obviously she lost her baby who recently was born. So she went around the people like crazy. Imagine a mother losing her baby, looking for him. Do you see my baby? Do you see my baby? Do you see my baby? Finally, she found the baby. She grabbed the baby next to her chest and she started breastfeeding him. A scene of love, a scene of mercy, a scene of compassion. Allahu Akbar. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asks his companions, the Prophet ﷺ used this situation to convey a message. Do you expect this mother to throw her baby in fire after this amount of love? No way, Ya Rasulullah. Allah is more merciful to His slaves than this mother to her baby. Can you imagine that? That should increase your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam. But again, the positive love,
the love which assertive love. That's the I'm looking for that word here. Assertive love, the assertive love. طيب. The second thing, you shouldn't despair. You yourself should not despair from Allah's mercy. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu said about this verse in the Quran, arja ayah fi kitabillah. If you want to bring out one verse from the Quran which gives so much hope, you know which verse? قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Tell my slaves who did it all, who transgressed, never despair from the rahmah, the mercy of Allah, because Allah forgives all sins. Imagine that. So as a Muslim, you shouldn't despair, brothers and sisters in Islam, from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never do. And this is, by the way, brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the tricks of shaitan. What do you mean? Do you, brothers and sisters in Islam, know that the name of shaitan is Iblis? Iblis in Arabic is derived from another noun called Al-Balas, which is despair. So imagine the name Iblis is derived from despair. Why? Because Iblis himself, when he committed the sin, he despaired. He given up that Allah will forgive him. And that is why he did not repent. So one of the things which Iblis will do to the Muslims, he will come and make you despair from the mercy of Allah. Oh man, I don't think, you're done? Oh, you're done, man. I don't think Allah will ever gonna forgive you. Forget about it. How many times we hear Muslims say like that? Oh, I done so much, I don't think I have a chance. I don't think so. No, you have a chance. Oh, son of Adam, look at this. Look at this other hadith I have for you here. Oh, son of Adam, look at this. Hadith Qudsi. Allah says, if your sins to reach the clouds of the sky, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. Oh, son of Adam, if you are to come to me with sins nearly as high as the earth, where, yeah, imagine, if we pile up your sins. وهذا المعنى في القرآن, this meaning in the Quran. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. That should fill your hearts with love for Allah and should fill your hearts with hope that when you commit a sin right away, you go back to Allah because He will accept you. Even if you commit it again, come back. Even if you commit it again, come back. Even if you commit it again, come back. He will accept you. You know, no human will do that. Just try wronging someone two, three times. He will forget about this guy. But Allah will give you chances always. SubhanAllah. Will always give you chances. طيب. The second thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, especially if you, and all of us should take on that rule of giving da'wah, is never make people despair from Allah's mercy. You're really not entitled to do that.
And guess who did this? Look at Hadith, the killer of the 100 souls.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we narrate this Hadith, we have to always point out the gravity and the magnitude of killing. It's an awful sin in Islam. But yet, in spite of this, this particular man killed 99 souls, but he wanted to repent. So he went to somebody who looks like a sheikh, but he did not study the names and the attributes like you. He did not study the name of Allah Ar-Rahman. He did not. So he comes to him and he tells him, I killed 99 people, do I have a chance? He said no to him. Well, even if this sheikh was smart, I mean, the guy killed 99 people. I mean, come on. What does it take to kill you? Just make him upset. Obviously. But if we read that hadith throughout, till the end, we know that this man ended up in Jannah because he really wanted to repent. And it looks like the environment where he was living is a wicked, corrupt environment. Imagine he killed 99 people and he's still free man. He is trying to, important brothers and sisters in Islam, that we do not make others despair. And there is another hadith out there, fi Sunan Abi Dawood, which is referred to here. Two brothers, one of them used to live in the top of the mountain from Bani Israel, and the other one used to live in the valley. So the one living on the top of the mountain, he was devout. He was consistent. But the one who's living down in the valley with the people, he's wishy-washy. He's, one day he's obedient and another day he's not. The righteous one came to visit the one who is wishy-washy. So subhanAllah, when he arrived, he found him sinning. So he saw him committing the sin. So you know what the brother said to his brother? Wallahi, la yaghfirullahu lak. Imagine this. By Allah, Allah will not forgive you. Oh. Allah revealed to the prophet, this is Bani Israel, at the time there was a prophet, Allah revealed, tell this person that I've forgiven the sins of his brother, and because of that statement he made, all his righteous deeds are gone. غَفَرْتُ لِأَخِيهِ وَأَحْبَطْتُ عَمَلَهِ. Start over now. That's why, brothers and sisters in Islam, we may see somebody committing a sin. You can't say you're going to hell. You can't. You can't do that. You never know. You never know. Number four, brothers and sisters in Islam, is to pursue the means to Allah's mercy. So, one of the ways that you worship Allah through this name, that you find out how can you get Allah's mercy to come to you. And if we look at the Quran and the Sunnah, four things which you should do. Have taqwa. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ. Allah said in Surah Al-A'raf, my mercy will include everyone, but I will write it, everything, I'm sorry, not one, everything, but I will write it to those who have taqwa. This is one. Two, إِنَّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ مِّنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. The mercy of Allah is near to those who have ihsan. Ihsan in the relationship with Allah. Ihsan in worshipping Allah. Ihsan in the relationship with the people. They forgive. They let go. Ihsan in relationship with the animals. So this is two. Three, Prophet Salih said to his people, لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون.
doing a lot of istighfar and making tawbah always is a means to get Allah's mercy. So those are three. But here is number four, which is the key. Irhamu man fil ardi yarhamkum man fis samaa. Man la yarham la yurham. Be merciful yourselves to those who are in earth. The one in the heaven will be merciful to you. Whosoever does not show mercy, he will not be showing mercy. So you need to pursue the means to receive the mercy of Allah. Four. One, taqwa. Two, ihsan. Three, tawbah. Four, you exercise the attribute of mercy, brothers and sisters in Islam. The last thing here, and will be done, is you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using the name Ar-Rahman in your dua. Allah says, قُلُ ادْعُوا اللَّهَ أَوِدْعُوا الرَّحْمَانَ أَيَّمَّا تَدْعُوا. So this is, you notice that we followed these four steps. Imagine with every name you should do that. This is, we did this as a practice. Remember when we practiced exercise the 12 rules with the attributes, we just exercised the four purposes or the four meanings in the Ahsaha, because al-Ihsa is for the names. Al-Ihsa is for the names. Jazakum Allah khayran, brothers and sisters in Islam. Inshallah, tomorrow we will have the seerah at the same time. I have one more lecture with the Right Belief series, The Greatest Name of Allah. And then we're going to start reviewing, inshallah, for the test, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. The phone line should be busy for you now, if you want to call in. Inshallah, let me post the phone number for you. So this way, if those who want to call, they can call. Inshallah, give me a call, 303-500-5101. We have Brother Muhammad Jalal Haq. Assalamu alaikum. Ismail or Adhan, one of the two. Ismail is here, that must be Adhan. AR, wa alaikum salam. Ahad Hakim. Faiz Qadir, wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our dear Aba Bakr Muhammad. Sister Muhammad, wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Shiraf from Sri Lanka, wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Yes, Brother Ismail, how are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, Sheikh, how are you?
We have one more lecture and then the test, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Go ahead, Ismail.
Sheikh, I have heard that Ar-Rahman is Allah's general mercy for the entire creation.
Yes.
Including the Hindus, Muslims, everybody. However, Ar-Rahim is only exclusively for the believer in the Al-Akhirah. Is that true?
That's, I have mentioned this in my book. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam, ya Sheikh, Samira from New York.
Yes, how are you doing, Sister Samira?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine.
Alhamdulillah, go ahead.
How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah.
I went to bed. For that is today, it's Monday. I fast every Monday, Thursday. But then when I woke up in the morning, it was already like 8:30. And then I remember today's Monday. But I haven't eaten anything, so I just continue. I wasn't sure if it's okay or not.
Your fasting is valid, sister. And may Allah accept from you, Ya Rabbil Alameen. As long as you did not, as long as you did not nullify your fasting with eating or drinking or any other nullifiers, then your fasting is valid. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one day he came to the house and he asked his wife, do you have something to eat? And that was in the morning, after the sun rose. And they said, we have no food in the house. He said, okay, then I'm going to fast today. So, and this was voluntary fast. The niyyah is mandatory for the obligatory fast before dawn.
Okay.
جزاك الله خيرا. May Allah accept from you, رب العالمين. Make dua for us, please.
Thank you. جزاك الله.
وإياكم. إن شاء الله. السلام. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our dear brother Ismail, those who mentioned that Ar-Rahman, it is true that Allah is merciful to all the creation. That is correct. So the first argument is 100%. لا أحد أصبر على أذى سمعه من الله. No one is more patient on harm he hears except Allah. Here they are, they say he has a son. Some of them say he does not exist and he provides for them. He gives them food and health and wealth and children and all that stuff. Because he created them. لأنه الذي خلقهم. فالرحمن, yes, it is true. And that's what we meant by a name which pertains to the essence. That his mercy includes everything he created. But Ar-Rahim is exclusive to his will. Whoever wants to have mercy on. Now, some scholars, they said this will be exclusive to the believers in the Day of Judgment. In the Day of Judgment. And this is okay, except there is one verse. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا in Surah Al-Baqarah. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِالنَّاسِ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. That Rahim was used for the nas in that verse. But the meaning is there, brother Ismail. But that verse can refute making the name Ar-Rahim exclusive to the believers in the Day of Judgment, if this is what you meant. But Ar-Rahim really has to do with the will of Allah. Whenever he wants to be merciful, he will be merciful to people. طيب جنين, I did share, okay. نعيمة أحمد, سلام عليكم. Please give us a call. آدم وجدو, حسن علي, I appreciate your hard work in جزاك الله خير brother حسن. May Allah accept from all of us, يا رب العالمين. المحجوب, brother آدم, وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. أم حنيفة, وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. أحمد شاهد, وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. عبد الرحمن بوني, yes, I'm glad somebody brought this up. I'm going to ask my admin if they can look for lecture number 3 in the series, because obviously I'm saying this is lecture number 14, but we only have 13. That's what I was told through various emails I received. That we only have 13, because lecture number 3 is not there. So, brother Ismail, can you please find out if we have a lecture number 3 and we give it a different name or something? But inshallah, hopefully the book will cover everything, inshallah. Ali and Sharjil, wa alaykum assalam. Sister Banazir Basha, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I need a phone number and I never got any information. Our admin, can you please text the sister my phone number and private, please, our admin. Please text my phone number to the sister, inshallah, on a private text message, or I think that should be a Facebook page. If you can message her on a Facebook page and pass on her number for her, please. Our sister Rahima, Facebook is not working. That's sometimes it mess up. Audio issues in the broadcast. Please stay tuned while we fix them. Are they fixed, brother Ismail? I didn't see any of that. Wa alaykum assalam. So hopefully it is fixed. Tufu, 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 tufu. Wa alaykum assalam, tufu, tufu. What a name, man. Plaraim, wa alaykum as-salam. Our Milad, brother Milad from San Diego, wa alaykum as-salam. Nishadi, wa alaykum salam. Ali, broadcast interruption again. I hope this was fixed because I was totally consumed in the lecture. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Khan Basha, wa alaykum salam. Muhammad Amin, wa alaykum salam. Naima, subhanallah. I heard Ar-Rahman. Okay, I think I answered that to Ismail. He called in. Sara Abd, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi. Our brother Tijan. Mawani Ibrahim, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi. Sharjil, is it a bid'ah to call upon Allah using all his names, forgiveness, pardon, in one setting? Example, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, Ya Afu, Ya Ghafur, Ya Ghafir. If the intention is making dua, there is nothing wrong with that. And the fashion that you do it, you know, there is no dancing, and you do it in a respectful way. Sheikh, may Allah reward you. Jazakallah khair. Ummu Junayna, wa alaykum as-salam. Shadia Akhtar, wa alaykum as-salam. Sarah, Sister Sarah, subhanallah, this is more merciful than a mother. Yes, yes, that's the hadith. Wa alaykum as-salam. Muhammad Amin. Afzal, I don't know what I want to work with you. Yeah, okay. Assalamu alaikum. This is off topic but cannot find an answer. Is it okay to invest with a contractor for state building project where one gives an amount to initiate a project with? You will have to look at this contract, brother, before we have to look at this contract. Muhammad Akhil, is the hadith about the most hatred permissible act in Islam? No, this hadith, this is a statement, but it's not a hadith. The Prophet never said that. One takes a certain percentage from... Okay, I really have to look at the whole thing. Muhammad Amin, it is about the difference between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. Okay, we're done with that. Muhammad Iqbal, wa alaykum as-salam. Okay, let me see here. I reside overseas, yet I try to contact or communicate with my first cousin, but neither do they back. Keep contacting them, Sarah. Keep contacting them. ليس الواصل بالمكافئ ولكن الواصل ولكن الواصل من قطعت رحمه رحمه فوصله. The one who upholds his kinship ties is not the one who rewards the others for contacting them, but the one they don't respond and you keep calling them. طيب تانو وعليكم السلام محمد أمين وعليكم السلام. Okay, Dura Saleh, what should I say to someone believes Gog and Magog is living among us right now within our societies? Tell him, where is that question here? Duran Saleh, he's saying, what should I do? Tell him to get a life. That's what you tell him. Seriously. Tell him, get a life. Be real. I had a nap today because I feel, okay, we don't have to know that. Heat made me feel. Okay, Hafizul Haq, wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ameen, 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 ya Rab. Rafiqul Islam, barakallahu feekum. Ruzdi Mureen, may Allah protect you, Ruzdi. Jazakallah khair for your dua. Okay, the straight path is saying, I will find and post. Excellent. The straight path, the link. Okay, good, good. We send the phone number. Okay, we'll send the phone number. Jazakallah khair, straight path. Lecture number 3 is in another name but cannot recall. Okay, so Sister Shiraf found it. Maybe you can communicate it to the straight path. Right here is the straight path, Sister Shiraf. So this way we can post it, inshallah. Ahmed Farah, how much surah should one read a day? As much as you can. Hello, Sheikh. I pray 5 times a day, alhamdulillah, but I only recite small surahs. That's excellent, Ahmed. Keep doing it, Ahmed, inshallah. Akhi, can you give us an example of Allah not showing mercy to those who do not show mercy? For example, Netanyahu and Assad don't show mercy, but Allah shows them mercy. How do you know, Akhi? How do you know that those people are happy? You know, how do you know? I'm asking you, how do you know?
Yes, in front of the camera, they look this way, but how do you know that those people are extremely depressed? Those people are extremely having an awful lifestyle. And who said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always seize people in this world? There are people Allah saves their punishment for the hereafter. فلا تتألى على الله يا أخي بارك الله فيك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
Yes.
يا إمام. So in this age of media and Facebook and WhatsApp, we see lots of people posting, especially of our late Muslims reciting the Quran in very, very beautiful voices. Now, I don't want to be an extreme and say extremist and say this is not allowed, but I thought in Surah Al-Ahzab, I believe it's verse 32, that is telling the
Are you talking about the singer who accepted Islam?
I'm talking about the singer, but there's also lots of ladies.
That is absolutely out of line. That is absolutely out of line. If a woman really fears Allah, she should not be doing that. And anybody who is close to the sister who may Allah guide her, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen, continue to guide her. They should advise her not to do that. Jazakallah khair. Barakallah fi. Okay, we're about to close here, so let me finish. Is there a way to measure sincerity? This only Allah can measure that, sister. Sheikh, is any way to update on the online Islamic school? Yes. Maybe 1 or 2 days. We're going to have the flyer out, inshallah. We're going to have the school. There is no question. The flyer is coming out 1 or 2 days. We're going to share that with you, inshallah, bi idhnillahi ta'ala. I was waiting. My parents are fighting each other. What do I need to do? Both want to listen to, they don't want to listen to. Help them, Muhammad. Help them, Muhammad. And you shouldn't say that in public, Muhammad, okay? Your name is Muhammad Amin. It's not even a nickname. And here you are talking about your parents in this way, Muhammad. Assalamu alaikum. Can you clarify this for me? Can a person marries in the masjid with a wali that is not relative or family member, then later tell the parents? This marriage is invalid. The wali is the father or whoever. If the father is not alive, you don't go and choose another wali. come on, man. I mean, that wali, your father has, the parent has to tell, if they are not in place, that why don't you go ahead and do it? That marriage is not valid, sister. Period. May Allah bless you. Okay, Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Karim. Can a lady breach openly? We talked about that yani, there is a special place for sisters, inshallah. Can there be a bid'ah in aqidah just as there is a bid'ah? Yeah, there are bid'ahs in aqidah, but bid'ah kufriya, bid'ah bid'iyya. Yani, we have to look into that. Amal Muhammad, I know after 1 year, but which month especially, which month is zakatul mal paid? Depends on when did you pay it last year. Zakatul mal is due every year on your income. So if you paid it in Ramadan last year, so then it's due this month in Ramadan. If you paid in Dhul Hijjah, then it's Dhul Hijjah. Dhul Qa'dah, then Dhul Qa'dah. Yeah, that's how you should look at it. What is the difference between Tabarakallah and Barakallah? This is Mudara and this is Madi. Okay, what is your duty? What is our duty when we see Alim is celebrating birthday? Make dua for him. After telling the father, they make another nikah again in the masjid. Alhamdulillah, I'm glad they did. Jazakumullahu khaira, brothers and sisters in Islam. Tomorrow, we have the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I always look forward to that, inshallah. May Allah reward you, and I will see you tomorrow, and I will have some updates on the school and on the quiz, on the competition, on both, inshallah. Tomorrow, I will have 2 updates. One for the school and one for the quiz, which we have 160 people almost signed up for it, inshallah. Tomorrow, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
تفت فؤادك الأيام فتا وتنحت جسمك الساعات نحتا وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتا تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها حتى إذا مت انتبهتا فكم ذا أنت مخوع وحتى متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا إن نهيت وإن أمرتا ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب به مقاتل من أردتا وكنز لا تخاف عليه لصا خفيف الحمل يوجد حيث كنتا.